Welcome to the presentation of our paper STEP, Segmenting and Tracking Every Pixel. In our paper, we tackle the task of video panoptic segmentation. The goal is to assign semantic classes and track identities to all pixels in a video. Our contributions are new benchmarks with two new datasets and a new metric. So why does segmentation matter? For example, in an autonomous driving setting, it's important to be able to estimate the drivable area. Moreover, the semantic understanding of all the surroundings is quite important, as well as the pixel-precise instance understanding. Of course, in such a scenario, tracking matters as well. It's important to anticipate the temporal evolution of objects, to be able to avoid any obstacles or do tasks like motion planning or pathfinding. In detail, our contributions are threefold. We provide the new Kitty Step and More Challenge Step datasets. We propose a novel pixel-centric metric SDQ to be able to measure the performance. And we study several baselines tackling both segmentation and tracking. Existing datasets tackle this task only partially, in our opinion. There exist the MOTS datasets for Kitty and MOD Challenge, but those have only pixel-level annotations for the trackable instances. Therefore, a large portion of the image remains unlabeled. Then, there's also the Cityscapes video panoptic segmentation dataset, but there, every clip has only 6 annotated frames, which means they span less than 2 seconds. Therefore, this dataset is much more focused on segmentation, while we propose a dataset that also requires long-term tracking. When we look at the dataset statistics from our proposed datasets and compare it with Cityscapes VPS, it is evident that Cityscapes contains many more sequences, while our datasets contain many more frames per sequence, and also the total number of frames is larger as every frame is annotated. Particularly if we look at the number of annotated frames per sequence and also at the track lengths per frame, it is clear that our datasets provide long sequences, and in those sequences we have long tracks that go up to over a minute. Such a setting is much closer to real-world applications in which robots, for example, would have a continuous stream as input and therefore build up much longer tracks. The second contribution of our work is the segmentation and tracking quality metric. It is the geometric mean of the association quality, which measures tracking performance, and the segmentation quality, measuring segmentation performance. Due to the geometric mean, methods are required to perform well in both segmentation and tracking. For the mathematical details of the association quality, please refer to the paper. However, here are 5 important properties of the association quality. The proposed association quality is designed to work at the pixel level of full videos. All pixels have an influence on the score, so no threshold is applied. We encourage the correction of mistakes. In terms of tracking, this means ID recovery. Both precision and recall should matter. And last but not least, we decouple errors, and therefore semantic segmentation errors are not penalized in the association quality, but in the segmentation quality. The segmentation quality is much simpler. We just resort to the well-established intersection over union to measure the segmentation quality. In the paper, we do a thorough analysis of all the metrics, and we are able to show that only the proposed SDQ metric is able to fulfill all the desired properties. Most resources related to this paper are already published, so you can find the 2 datasets with their corresponding test servers. You can find the code online. We have also done a full workshop around this topic at ICCV, and you can find an extended version of this video on YouTube. So in summary, we present a new perspective on the task of video panoptic segmentation. We provide a new benchmark step, focusing on measuring algorithm performance at the most detailed level possible, which means taking every pixel into account. Our benchmark and metric are designed for evaluating algorithms in a real-world setting, in which understanding long-term tracking performance is really important. And we believe that this work provides an important step towards a dense and pixel-precise video understanding.